Eric with Cybermedics, and we're here to talk about the Ecobee Smart Thermostat. We recently had it installed with our brand new central air conditioning unit. Once you put the physical plate, wire it in, the main unit snaps into that physical plate. It was an easy install. Even though we had it done professionally, I believe anyone with basic DIY skills could do the installation. The model number was an Echo Bravo STATE5P-01. One of the things that attracted us to it is its compatibility with not only Siri, but also Alexa and Google's smart speaker system. So it has wide-ranging compatibility with the smart speakers. It has something called Follow Me, which basically is occupancy sensors that you can add to the unit. That way it can detect whether someone's home and you can adjust the air conditioning or heating settings based upon whether someone is at the home or not. This is an important aspect for high humidity climates. Sometimes you can have something that is, you know, you can set the thermostat and it might be cool enough, but the humidity is really high, which can cause mold in a home setting. So it works just like a humidistat, but it's built into the unit itself. The warranty is standard with 3 years. If you have it installed by a professional, they extend that to 5 years. This video shows our HVAC technician installing it and some of the questions that I had for him as we were putting it in. Before we get started with the installation video, I just wanted to give a shout out to Sunshine Air Conditioning. This is not a paid promotion. Ray Watson and the technicians were fantastic. Some of the best service I've received from a company in a decade plus. If you're in Central Florida and considering an air conditioning system, I would highly recommend considering Sunshine Air Conditioning. So with that, let's get started. You have good success with these Ecobees?
Yeah, a lot of people like them, and I've grown to like them.
Uh-huh.
When I first started installing them, I didn't, but they've gotten a lot easier.
Yeah, I think one of the HVAC guys said he liked the Nest better because it was just easier to turn the dial, but these seem like they have better reviews.
Yeah, but they've had a lot of problems with the Nest. With them just randomly changing temperatures. Just a lot of just randomness. They'll have a set schedule and then they'll go off that set schedule and just go to whatever temperature they want to go to. You know, their max setting 89 degrees. I've lost the screw.
Oh,
sorry. What I've heard.
Uh-huh.
And that's just not something I like.
That's nice they have a little level thing built on it, huh?
Yeah. Where's these screws?
So that's red to red, huh?
Yeah, it's red to RC.
RC?
There's an RH over here, but it won't work if you plug it into RH. Oh. And these thermostats go, they can do anywhere from heat pumps to dual fuel furnaces.
Oh, okay.
It's just how you program it.
Okay.
And when you fire it up. You're running the common wire, which means you don't run batteries. This thing doesn't run off batteries anyway. But
what's the white one for?
White one's your heat.
Oh, that's for heat. Okay. Mm-hmm.
Now, normally, like on a heat pump, you would have an OOB. And then
well, just tell me briefly what each of these are.
So, red is your constant power.
Uh-huh.
Green is your fan.
Okay.
Yellow is your cooling.
Okay.
Blue is your common wire, which just runs a 24-volt current circuit or connection circuit. Uh-huh. And then white is your heating.
Oh, okay.
Which is your turns on and off your furnace.
Neat.
And then it just clips on.
Wow. And it's powered from the HVAC.
Yep. It runs that blue wire runs your circuit.
Oh, okay. So there's no battery or anything inside this.
No batteries whatsoever. Okay. If this is off, something's wrong with your unit.
Oh, okay.
And most of the time it's a float switch,
which
would be your drain being backed up.
Right, right. So. Okay. Fantastic. Thank you, sir.
Mm-hmm.
That concludes our video demonstration of the Ecobee Smart Home Thermostat. Would love to hear about your experiences with it. How has it been for automation, the Alexa functions or Siri functions? Which smart speaker systems are you using it with? What difficulties have you run into in trying to climate control your house? Have you used any other brands? Do you agree with the technician's assessment that it is better than the Google Nest and that the Google Nest is subject to random temperature changes? Please hit that subscribe button. We would love to have your support. If you have any questions or comments, post them below and have a great and wonderful automation day.